Hi, my name is Nina Fitzgerald. I'm a diver, conservationist and wildlife presenter at Australia Zoo.
We now find ourselves here in the 21st century where if you're not thinking sustainably, you're not thinking.
Some are calling this the Anthropocene Epoch. This is the first time in known history where one species is literally changing the ecosystems in a way that is detrimental to their own survival.
As carbon dioxide warms the planet, it also seeps into the oceans and acidifies them. Sometime this century, they may become so acidic that corals can no longer construct reefs. This would register in the geological record as a reef gap. Reef gaps have marked each of the past five major mass extinctions. Overfishing, ocean acidification, and pollution have two features in common. First, they're accelerating. They're growing broadly in line with global economic growth so that they can double in size every couple of decades. Second, they have extreme inertia. There's no real prospect of changing their trajectories in less than 20 to 50 years. Overfishing can bring down reefs because fish are one of the key functional groups that hold reefs together. Detailed forensic studies of the global fish catch by Daniel Pauly's lab at the University of British Columbia confirm that global fishing pressure is still accelerating even as the global fish catch is declining. Overfishing is already damaging reefs worldwide and it's set to double and double again over the next few decades. Ocean acidification can also bring down reefs because it affects the corals themselves. Corals can make their calcareous skeletons only within a special range of temperature and acidity of the surrounding seawater. But the oceans are acidifying as they absorb increasing amounts of carbon dioxide from our atmosphere. Research led by Ophir Goldberg of the University of Queensland shows that corals will be pushed outside their temperature acidity envelope in the next 20 to 30 years absent effective international action on emissions.
And we have even less of a handle on pollution. We know that nutrients, particularly nitrogenous ones, are increasing, not only in coastal waters, but also in the open ocean. And we know that coral reefs just can't survive in nutrient-rich waters.
These conditions only encourage the microbes and jellyfish that will replace coral reefs in coastal waters. We can say, though, with somewhat certainty that unstopped pollution will force reefs beyond their survival envelope by mid-century. This includes hydrocarbon spills, toxic and radioactive wastes. The World Federation for Coral Reef Conservation compiles and distributes this information on a freely accessible public forum. Prior to this, it only existed on the secure servers of governmental entities and private corporations. It is widely acknowledged that a platform like this will benefit scientists, educators, first responders, and volunteers wanting to take initiative in cleanup efforts should a disaster occur. For more information on specific programs, take a look at our website, www.wfcrc.org.
So dare to care, donate today, and join our efforts to form a frontline defence for our coral.